The Alec Cantor Real Estate Show.
Thanks so much for tuning in, guys. I wanted to do a quick deep dive on preparing your home for listing photos. Now, photos online are one of the first impressions that a buyer will have on your home. With millions of people searching online every single day, it's very important that we make sure that we prepare soundly for the photography that's going to be representing your home. Now let's go ahead and talk about the exterior of the home, the curb appeal. The first thing that's going to draw buyers into your home is the exterior of it. So we want to make sure that we get this right. Of course, you're going to want to go ahead and prepare your lawn by cutting it, trim your hedges if you can, remove all pine straw or leaves from the yard as well as the roof. More likely than not, you're going to be taking care of the yard a couple of days before the photos are taken. So when you go ahead and you remove all of the leaves, pine straw, yard clippings, things of that nature, and you put it in a trash bag, make sure that's out of the way of the photographer, so that way those aren't included in the photos. Other things that you want to make sure are out of the way of photos are any cars in the driveway, trash cans outside, you can go ahead and put those in the garage, any sports flags or political signs for obvious reasons. Also, trust me, I love garden gnomes and pink flamingos in the yard. But you want to go ahead and remove those as well. It's going to take away from the attention of what's important, which is your home. Next, keep in mind when I order photography for my clients, we make sure to get drone photos. So when it comes to aerial photos, you're going to make sure that the yard is nice and tidy. This is going to include any dog toys or kids toys, any pool floaties or the spaghetti noodle things. Also, if you have any lawn chairs, go ahead and make sure that those are not disorganized. Also, if you can, try to clean up after your dog as well. You don't want that in the photos. Let's go ahead and move inside of the kitchen to one of the biggest selling points. The first thing most people are going to notice is your countertops. Go ahead and declutter that completely. And when I say completely, I mean completely. Get rid of any coffee makers, toasters, blenders, even fun things like waffle makers and margarita machines, and get rid of your knife block as well. And even if you can, little things like salt shakers and pepper shakers. Now, speaking of the countertops, some people may have lighting underneath their cabinets. Go ahead and turn that on for the photos. It's really gonna make your backsplash pop. Now, we talked about underneath the cabinets. A big tip that a lot of people miss is the decorations on top of the cabinets. If you have that, go ahead and bring those down. It's gonna draw too much attention to the ceiling, which will in turn make the room feel smaller. A big tip, make sure to wipe down any stainless steel appliances if you have them. You don't want hand smudges showing up in the photos. Last but not least, go ahead and remove any trash cans from the kitchen. This also includes in the living room or any other rooms as well. Moving on to the living room, you wanna make sure that your couch is looking nice and tidy. You can do this by removing any blankets and making sure that your pillows are orderly. To make the rooms feel nice and big, go ahead and make sure that you're opening all drapes completely and you're opening all of your blinds as well. Now, when it comes to the wall, we're gonna wanna depersonalize as much as possible. So go ahead and remove any posters that you may have, family pictures too. You may not want those online for random buyers to see. Now, if you're a professional athlete, political figure, or a celebrity, go ahead and remove all of your trophies, awards, and accolades. That way you can remain private if you choose to. You wanna make sure that you're vacuuming. That way you're showing off your nice, beautiful carpet or floors. And last but not least, you wanna make sure that there's no children or dog toys out in the open. Now, moving to the bedrooms, you wanna make sure that you have your beds made, your pillows fluffed. If you have a bed skirt, make sure that's nice and even. Also, you want to make sure that your blanket's looking nice and even too. Now, just like removing items from the countertops in the kitchen, we want to make sure that we're removing items from your dressers as well. Now, one thing a lot of people forget about is the dirty clothes hamper. Go ahead and get that out of the photos. We don't want people talking about how much laundry that you need to do. Another big tip, if you have mounted TVs in the house, try to make sure that you're hiding the wires and cables coming from them as much as possible. If you can't, no big deal. I'll go ahead and make sure these are edited out. Now, when it comes to the shower and sinks, we want to make sure that we're decluttering and depersonalizing as much as possible. So go ahead and remove shampoo, loofahs, washcloth, soap bars. We don't want potential buyers talking about what kind of shampoo or toothpaste you do or don't use. Also, a big tip, the cameras don't like fabric. So go ahead and remove your bath mats, towels, robes, and hand towels as well. Now, the last thing a lot of people overlook are pet items. I have a dog. He's fantastic. But unfortunately, some people either don't like pets or maybe they're allergic. So we want to make sure that we're removing any dog or cat beds, toys, or bowls out of the photos. That way we don't turn anyone off from coming to view the home. The last thing that you're going to need to do is connect with a photographer. Don't worry. I work with a professional photographer that I'll connect you with when we go ahead and market and list your home to sell. Thanks for tuning in and good luck getting your home sold.